Hello everyone, I welcome you all to this session, and today we shall discuss about production control. Introduction. The production department of any food outlet is planned and set up with the sole purpose of satisfying the demands of the customer and earn its reward as profit. The planning of all other departments is in accordance with the functioning of the kitchen and the menu planned. In the production of food, the four major factors to be considered for applying strict controls procedures are loss from inefficient purchasing, wastage during processing, wastage due to overproduction, and excessive portion sizes. Objectives. In this episode, the following aspects of production control are going to be discussed: forecasting, fixing of standards, standard purchase, stores discrepancies, duties of the chef. Let us move on to the first objective, forecasting. The main function of the preparation or production stage of the catering cycle is to prepare according to volume forecasting, that is, number of portions of each item of food to be prepared, and ensure that all food prepared is in accordance with the targets, that is, standards set. A constant check is made of the actual cost of all the items of food prepared. This check is the comparison with standard costs. If the variance is substantial, immediate corrective action is essential to prevent losses. The most important aspect is the revision of standard recipes of the items offered on the menu, which should be on a periodic basis. The information for the assessment of the performance of the production department are cost of the raw materials coming into the kitchen, total of which can be got from the requisitions, and the total sales figures obtained from the accounts department. Food cost report is prepared and compared with the budgeted food cost. Volume forecasting. Forecasting is using the available data to predict what is likely to occur in the future. In the food industry, which deals with highly perishable products, this advanced planning is very important. The objectives of volume forecasting are to predict the total number of meals to be sold at each meal period, to facilitate purchasing of the appropriate items, to ensure availability of all necessary ingredients, to compare the actual volume of business with the potential forecast. Volume forecasting is in two stages. Initial forecast, prepared in advance of the event or period under consideration. This gives the potential business to be achieved, and later, after the event, compared with the actual trading results to measure the performance. For forecasting, the required information is gathered from past records or sales history. Sales history is the record of the number of portions of each item sold every time it is appeared on the menu. This information is obtained from the analysis of daily sales summary of the restaurant. This information can be arranged as per the requirement by item, popularity of items are analyzed, by day of the week, the choice of items on different days of the week, daily, sales on a daily basis. The sales of any outlet is affected by festivals, political agenda, visit of state dignitaries, change in weather, room occupancy of the hotel in which the outlet is situated, room occupants dining in the restaurant, banquet bookings or conferences, customer choice due to the timing of work, surrounding competition, spending power of customers, age of customers. Final forecast. This is a more accurate source. This is worked out prior to the day of the event. Compilation is based on trend of a few days in the past, that is, if the customer count has increased or decreased, or any item sales has increased or decreased. These information change the anticipated sales. Sudden change in political situation, weather, which prevents customers from visiting. All these factors influence the quantities of food to be prepared, therefore the sales. Now we shall move on to the next aspect, that is fixing of standards. The four stages in the reducing loss from inefficient purchasing and processing, overproduction and excessive portion sizes are fixing of standards, standard yield, which is related to standard purchase specification, standard recipe, which helps to fix the standard portion size, standard portion size from which the standard cost is fixed, standard cost from which the selling price calculated. Definition of standards. Standards may be defined as rules or measures established for making comparisons and judgments. In business, these standards are set for judging the event to which results meet the expectations. Determining the food cost involves many procedures. It begins with the establishing of standards and standard procedures in all the areas of food handling. Also, from the past records, that is, sales history, the numbers of portions sold is known. From this information, how much is likely to be sold in the future can be calculated. This is forecasting. If an outlet can forecast portion sales with accuracy, then it can predict costs with accuracy. This would be the goal set. The goal becomes the standard. It is possible to review the actual performance of production and selling departments to know whether the goals set were met or not. Analysis of the reasons for not meeting the standards will bring appropriate changes in the operating procedures so that the performance in the future will be according to the standards set. Quality standard. This is the degree of acceptability of raw materials and finished products. This is graded by weight, volume, or count. It is important to establish which grade will be used for the preparation of a particular item. The quality standard applies to the finished products also, where grading by weight, volume, or count is essential. Quality purchasing. If the kitchen is to produce products of consistent quality, it must use raw materials of consistent quality. The formation of suitable specifications for purchase of quality raw materials will help in the formation of profitable menu. The menu is considered successful if the portion size and portion cost are most suitable with the specifications arrived at, as these are the considerations for fixing the selling prices. The most important aspect to be considered for fixing the selling price is the spending power of the customer, around which this exercise of arriving at a particular selling price for every item on the menu revolves. Quantity standard. Quantity standards must be established for the day-to-day operations of the control cycle, purchasing, receiving, issuing, production and selling, to minimize loss and not to maximize profit. Standard cost. In addition to quality and quantity standards, it is important to fix cost standards or standard cost for the operation of the business. It is useful in measuring the effectiveness of an operation. With the comparison of standard costs and actual performance costs, the effective use of food raw materials can be assessed. Cost standards are necessary in the cost control process because it provides a means of comparing what we are doing with what we should be doing. To assess the performance by the standard cost, the following standards have to be fixed. Standard yield. The term yield may be defined as the edible or usable part of a food item which is available after preparation and cooking. To arrive at the standard yield, tests on food are conducted. Raw food test. To determine the count and weight for vegetables and fruits used after waste and cuttings are removed for specific uses. Butchering test. To fix the actual cost of meat, poultry, fish after waste and trimmings have been considered. Once the standard yield is fixed for different food items used, then the performance of the kitchen can be measured. With this standard yield, the following standards can be fixed. Standard purchase specification, standard recipe, standard portion size, standard portion cost. The performance of the kitchen department can be assessed and reasons for not meeting the standards can be detected. Let us now move on to the third objective, standard purchase. From the standard yield, the standard purchase specifications for every commodity purchased is made. It is the concise description of the quality, size, and weight or count factor required for a particular commodity. From the standard yield, the food items best suited for the kitchen is fixed. That becomes the standard purchase specification. Helps in competitive biddings among suppliers and also for arriving at the purchasing prices. Supply is according to specification set every time an item is ordered. The receiving department accepts raw materials according to the specification. By the specification, buying the performance of the kitchen and service departments can be measured. This predicts quantity to be sold and the money to be earned as sales, which can be compared with the actual sales. Standard recipe. For any food service outlet, the important factors are quality and uniformity of food. To ensure these, a definite recipe or formula is to be established for each dish. Cooking is essentially a manufacturing process in which raw materials are processed into finished products ready to be sold to the customers. The standard recipe lists ingredients and quantities to be used and procedures to be followed every time a particular item is produced. It helps to maintain consistency of taste, appearance, and acceptance. If the same ingredients are used in the correct proportions and the same procedures are followed, then identical products should be produced each time the standard recipe is used for the preparation of the product. The most important marketing aspect is customers are served an item of identical quality every time it is ordered. The objectives of standard recipe are: the standard recipe is a result of standard yield and the standard purchase specification for every item of food purchased. The nutritional value can be calculated as the quality and quantity of the raw materials are known. From this standard, the number of portions to be made can be calculated. Therefore, the exact quantity of raw materials can be ordered. From the standard recipe, the standard portion size can be fixed. The food cost can be calculated from the standard portion, which is arrived at from the standard recipe when quality and quantity of ingredients are known. The standard recipes for all the items in the menu are documented. They include photographs about the finished products. That serves as a guide for kitchen staff and for illustrating on the menu cards. Standard portion size. The most important standard to be set by any selling outlet is the portion size. It is the quantity of any item to be served for a fixed selling price every time that particular item is ordered. It represents the weight or volume of a food item to be served in relation to the food cost and the selling price of the item. Equipment for standard portion sizes are used in the kitchen to maintain the quantity served to the customers. This ensures control over the quantity served. The most commonly used equipments are scoops, ladles, spoons, measuring jugs, graded tea coffee dispensers, weighing scales, standard sized baking trays, cups, glasses and bowls. Standard portion cost. With appropriate standards in effect, it is possible to fix the cost of one portion of any item prepared in the kitchen. When standard recipes are in use, it is possible to calculate the standard cost of every item prepared for sale. A standard recipe is for a predetermined quantity of standard portions. From this standard recipe, the total cost of preparing a fixed number of portion of the item is arrived at. From the number of portions prepared, the cost of every portion is calculated. The advantage of arriving at the standard portion cost is, selling price can be fixed, total cost of all the items sold in the outlet can be calculated. From the quantity of raw material received, the number of portions to be prepared is fixed. From the number of portions made, the potential revenue to be earned can be anticipated. Comparison of the number of portions prepared and the number of portions sold is possible. The main function of the kitchen is to prepare according to the volume forecast when the number of portions are predicted. Let us now move on to the fourth objective, discrepancy in the stores. It means the difference between booked stock and actual stock. This can happen for the following reasons: material stolen by the store staffs, material received and not recorded, materials issued but not recorded, over issue and under issue, deterioration, shrinkage, evaporation, wastage, etc. Pilferage, that is small items taken by big people. Types of discrepancy. There may be either overage or shortage. Overage means actual stock being more than the booked stock. Shortage means actual stock being less than the booked stock. When there is discrepancy, if it is in the allowable limit, it may be written off. But if it is higher quantity, then it has to be inquired in responsibility fixed. Let us now move on to the last objective, duties of the chef. The chef in any establishment has the overall responsibility for the organization, productiveness and efficiency of the kitchen. The duties of the chef. Menu planning. The chef demonstrates his knowledge and skill when planning the menu. Along with the fundamentals such as the overall balance and appeal of the menu offered, the chef also should be conscious of the cost of the menu to achieve the required kitchen profit. Engaging kitchen staff. The chef establishes the number of staff necessary to carry out the necessary tasks based on the type of the menu offered and the estimated number of meals to be served. He is responsible for maintaining the labor cost of the kitchen to be within the fixed percentage. Kitchen organization. This is the allocation of duties such that all the staff integrate and work as a team. The chef is responsible for the delegation of duties and fixing individual responsibilities, ensuring all staff are instructed in specifications, standards and portion control. Management information. As an administrator, the chef is responsible for keeping the management informed on the efficiency of the kitchen operation. Statistical data is provided so that the budget and forecast for future operations can be planned to assess the profitability of the kitchen. If the profit percentage varies from the set target percentage, then the chef takes corrective action by investigating the possibilities such as excessive wastage, pilfering, portion control not adhered to, fluctuations in the prices of commodities, not analyzing the menu sales and revising the menu. Service coordination. Along with the responsibility of smooth flow of food service to customers, the chef must help the service staff to keep the customers satisfied. The chef is responsible for the sales of the issues from the kitchen, resulting in profit either as cash or as charge to the customer's account. It's now time to wrap up this session, so let us conclude by saying, the chef controls the food production procedures, and also be aware of the changing trends in the market to adopt that which is profitable and update himself with customer preferences to make changes accordingly to achieve the profit and increase the business. Thank you.